Our next presentation is by a duo. Loy Tuan Yee and Azmi Zainal are respectively the CEO and COO of Farmfresh, Malaysia's number one fresh dairy brand. Farmfresh began with Loy's dream to produce fresh and pure dairy, just as nature intended. After purchasing a plot of land in Johor and importing 60 Holstein Jersey cows from Australia, Loy set up Farmfresh. As the business grew, Loy enlisted the help of his old friend Azmi to expand the company's operations, and the rest is history. Here to share with us about Farmfresh's journey in addressing the needs to produce high-quality products and growing the business alongside communities for the Malaysian consumers, please welcome Loy Tuan Yee and Azmi Zainal.
Thank you, Edmund, for having us. If you look at some of those pictures, you'll probably realize that how me and Azmi started 10 years ago. It was indeed a very, very daunting task that I'm not sure whether Azmi and I know what we're going in or not. But thank God, I think fast track 10 years today that we are fully integrated dairy player in Malaysia. And that what we did is that we brought from grass to glass. Basically, that's our business model. And I think over the past couple of days, you know, there are many speakers talking about sharing about sustainability, environment, and things like that. I think we are very conscious of our business in the sense that when we started out to do this dairy in the tropic, Malaysia is very hot, very humid, the weathers are very, very challenging. And for that reason, I think in the past, there isn't many success dairy operation in Malaysia due to that fact, I think. So what happened is that led us to, we have the privilege to acquire the Australian Friesian Sahiwal breed that was developed by the Queensland government way back in the late 60s and early 70s. Now with that breed, I think that gave us that a genetic platform that we are able to do dairy farming in a sustainable manner in Malaysian weather context. Yeah. So that's where I think we have grown to what we are today because we're able to do it in a sustainable manner. I think we place a lot of emphasis in terms of our workers' well-being, you know, the people that we have, the well-being of our customer, for example, right? These are some of the very important core value that we hold true. And not only that, I think even in our farm, just 2-3 months ago, we were accredited from US organizations that we are the first company in Asia, dairy farming company that been certified humane. So I think this is important to us and we are very proud of it as well in the sense that, you know, beside the people, the customers and even our dairy animal, for example, we have to ensure that, you know, we provide them with a good environment and then they have enjoyable living with us as well. And I think that is one of the reasons that I think that all these things need to be taken into consideration. With regards to Farmfresh brand today, you know, we emerge as the number one fresh milk categories in Malaysia, thanks to all the Malaysian supporters. I think I will attribute this owing to the fact that I think the very core value of our company principles in the sense that we truly believe in the well-being of our customer. That is very, very important. So over the years, I think for Farmfresh brand, we are very conscious about ingredients, you know, what we produce. You probably realize that you can't find any Farmfresh product with preservative, with, you know, coloring, for example, to attract the kids and things like that. I mean, these are really no good for our customer well-being, right? So we are very, very particular about the ingredient that we use over the years. Say, for example, when we developed Kruma milk, which is very, very popular, that milk is made from a real Kruma concentrate that is carefully selected. Like last couple of months, we launched our banana milk, for example. It is not by flavors or essence. It's made with real banana puree. I think that kind of things that have probably where the consumers start to appreciate our brand, and therefore, you know, over the last 10 years, thank God, we have been growing, you know, year in, year out. Now, with regards to our company, as we grow, we are also very mindful that, you know, we wanted to grow our company in a sustainable manner. We do not want to be a problem to our communities. We do not want to be deemed as an irresponsible company, for example, right? So I think the business that we are in, you know, inevitably, as you scale up the daily operations, we will have, you know, some environmental matters that we need to manage, for example. For some reason, sadly, you know, everybody blaming cow for the GHG gas house emission, for example. So I think we are very conscious of what we are doing. I think as a result, over the years, I think we spent a lot of efforts to ensure that, you know, all the waste, you know, in our farms are all been managed in such a way that, you know, environmentally is sustainable. All this manure slurry, for example, that comes out, you know, we decant them, we separate them, and then, you know, all the waters actually go out as irrigations to nurture back the soils, to ensure that, you know, the grass are growing, you know, well. And then all those solids are actually, we probably raised the biggest earthworm in Malaysia, I think, by now, because the amount of solids that we actually feed to all those earthworm to produce a worm casting and then goes back to the soil to nourish the soil and produce a very good organic grass for our dairy animal, for example. So I think we are very mindful of that. And I think in the coming years, we are also investing tens of millions, you know, into renewable energy. For example, you know, all our rooftop, we will install solar panel, for example, to generate the energies, you know, to run the fan, to keep our dairy cow cool and ventilated. And also, for example, all the methane gas that, you know, that is charged from the biogas, we will use the biogas technologies to trap those energy and convert them to replace the biofuels, the diesels that we actually use to do our boilers. So I hope that in the coming years, you know, as we grow, we will continue to work hard consciously and putting in the efforts to ensure that we produce one of the lowest carbon emissions dairy product for our Malaysian to enjoy. Yeah, I think socially, we are very conscious as well. Our workers, you know, the communities that we are living in terms of creating opportunities, you know, for some of these social entrepreneurs that, you know, whereby they can make a good living out of it, you know, impact people's life, changing people's life and things like that. For that, I think I will leave it to my partner Azmi to share our journey. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum. Hi, everybody. Saya nak kongsi sikit salah satu keunikan yang ada dalam Farm Fresh ni ialah bagaimana kita memasarkan susu. Banyak retailer pasarkan susu di pasar raya, Horeca Market dan market-market lain lah. Tapi dekat unitnya dekat Farm Fresh, kita ada satu unit pemasaran yang kita panggil Home Dealer. Program ni saya panggil dia Kongsi Rezeki. Permulaannya dia bermula very humble beginning, yang mana pada tahun 2016 ada beberapa orang kawan yang datang jumpa saya, kehilangan pekerjaan, bisnes dia drop, tanya apa yang saya boleh bantu. Saya cakap, kalau boleh jaga lembu, jaga lembu lah, tapi takkan you orang dah tua-tua nak jaga lembu. Saya cakap, yang ada boleh jual susu lah, you cubalah jual susu. So some of these friends start jual susu, dia orang jual dekat pasar malam, jual dekat pasar tani, jual dekat sekolah, and then it can, dia boleh dapat hasil yang agak menggalakkan, dan tapi dia tak grow cukup-cukup untuk dia dalam 2-3 ribu sebulan dia boleh dapat. Dan pada waktu itu saya datang satu idea daripada diri saya, saya cakap kenapa tak peluang ini kita pecahkan lagi. Cuba you cari kawan-kawan you yang lain yang berminat untuk jadi home dealer. Saya panggil dia home dealer. Kongsikan rezeki yang you dapatnya bersama dengan orang lain. Jadi kita start home dealer dan dia orang mula lantik kawan-kawan dia. Di kalangan kawan-kawan dia, semuanya daripada networking yang berhampiran dia, mula-mula dilantik kawan-kawan pejabat dia untuk tolong jual susu, kerana mereka nampak jual susu ni mudah. Dan paling mudah saya cakap, dekat satu taman carilah suri rumah tangga yang tak bekerja ni, supaya selain daripada dia jaga anak, they can earn some money untuk support keluarga dia. Dan 80% daripada home dealer kita pada hari ini, kalau kata ikut kita punya statistik home dealer kita, yang home dealer berdaftar kita ada 800 orang, stokis yang asal-asal tu dia dah ranking stokis sekarang ni. Stokis lebih kurang 45 orang sekarang ni, dan agent yang menjual ni 1,300 orang. Dan dia dah merebak sehingga lebih kurang 2,500 orang agent. Saya panggil dia ni social micropreneurship lah. Very micro, dia orang start dulu kalau you tengok dengan polystyrene box. Masa tu kita mula-mula kita tak ada tau. Kita tak ada susu UHT. Dia orang kena gunakan polystyrene box, kena beli ice dan dia orang kena beli chiller. Dan kita kena bagi kredit dekat dia, dia orang kurang modal. Dan sehingga hari ini kita support kredit untuk home dealer ni lebih kurang saya ingat 5 juta satu bulan yang kita support untuk dia orang move on. Tapi dia orang dah grow sekarang ni, kalau kita tengok daripada dia orang punya grow, kita tengok daripada dia orang punya grow ni dah ada yang pada hari ini yang berpendapatan, kalau kita tengok perata pendapatan daripada statistik kita, dia dah pendapatan kalau setakat stokis ni pendapatan dia dah 5 angka. Home dealer pun dah ada pendapatan 5 angka dengan jual susu saja. Dan 80% daripada mereka ni adalah suri rumah tangga. Dan pendapatan purata pula antara RM700 hingga RM5,000. Depend lah kalau dia buat serius, dia buat secara full time, dia akan dapat lebih pendapatan. Dan kebanyakan daripada mereka ni sekarang, dulu dia orang store barang-barang dekat rumah sampai dia punya rak TV pun susu tu dah jadi rak TV tu. Tak muat rumah. Tapi sekarang dia orang dah mula berkembang, ramai. Saya ingat 200 daripada mereka ni dah ada kedai sendiri, dah ada lori yang mereka invest. Jadi ini apa yang kita buat ni betul-betul mengubah dia punya life changing tu. Mengubah nasib kehidupan dia orang daripada seorang suri rumah tangga tadi dah jadi seorang entrepreneur melalui social micro. Very, very micro. They start with RM300, RM400, beli kemudian compounding modal, cari rakan-rakan lain untuk bantu sama, dan dia orang nampak jual susu ni mudah, dan dia pada masa yang sama berkempen untuk orang. Dan saya rasa mereka juga adalah salah seorang agent yang membantu menaikkan kita punya per kapita minum susu kita. Dan saya nak ambil satu study case lah. Kita tunjuk satu study case. Ini adalah staff saya tau. Kerja dia merchandiser. Nama dia Hasnah. Dia merchandiser saja. Okay. Hasnah gaji dia 1,200, kalau campur overtime 1,500. Bila saya bagi dia peluang untuk jadi stokis, sekarang Hasnah punya jualan satu bulan purata 500 hingga 600 ribu ringgit, dan kita pula bagi peluang lagi kepada dia. So dekat Farm Fresh ni, whenever we have opportunity, we share dengan kita punya dealer. So di bawah Hasnah ada kumpulan lebih kurang 50 hingga 60 orang home dealer dengan jualan 500 ribu hingga 600 ribu. Dan Hasnah juga kita bagi bisnes untuk serve kita punya all key outlet kita. Dan jualan Hasnah satu bulan mencapai, satu tahun saya ingat boleh mencapai lebih kurang dalam hampir 15 juta. Jadi daripada seorang merchandiser yang bekerja dengan syarikat, akhirnya sekarang ni dia dah jadi status dia dah sama macam distributor. Tapi kalau you nak jadi distributor di syarikat-syarikat besar, let's say macam another dairy company ataupun food company, you kena letak bank guarantee. You kena letak you kena mesti ada facilities yang besar, you mesti ada lori, you mesti ada pekerja yang ramai. Tapi dekat Farm Fresh, we give this opportunity, we start them from very, very micro. Dan akhirnya sekarang dalam jangka masa 6 tahun, saya nampak perubahan kehidupan diorang pada hari ini betul-betul memberi satu perubahan dan impact yang besar. Dan bukan jumlah yang sedikit, tapi jumlah yang ramai. Dekat Farm Fresh juga, we share our opportunity. Masa kita dapat kontrak susu sekolah satu Malaysia, kita bagi mereka ni peluang untuk jadi pengedar supaya satu orang dapat berapa sekolah. Supaya dia orang boleh share daripada saya lantik transporter ataupun saya lantik syarikat-syarikat penghantaran, saya lantik mereka ni, saya bagi-bagikan. Kita bagi-bagikan satu orang 20 sekolah, 30 sekolah untuk dia orang dapat a very sustained income. Tapi Susu sekolah dia kontrak dari tahun ke tahun. Jadi untuk mereka ni invest, because they all can get good income bila supply dekat sekolah ni. Tetapi bila kontrak tu tiap tahun kena tender, dia orang tak bolehlah nak melabur, nak beli van. Padahal dia memerlukan van untuk buat ni. Tapi oleh kerana kontrak yang pendek satu tahun, tak dapat dia orang nak supply. Tapi kalau kata ada satu kontrak yang panjang 3 tahun, 3 plus 1 tahun. So usahawan-usahawan ni boleh melabur untuk ada kenderaan sendiri, ada kedai sendiri yang lebih proper. Jadi benda-benda yang ini kolaborasi antara kita dengan kerajaan ni patut kita selaraskan supaya selain daripada government invest untuk budak-budak minum susu sekolah, limpahan juga kepada usahawan-usahawan tempatan. Mereka ni semua rakyat Malaysia yang memerlukan pendapatan. Dan pada hari ini, kalau kita tengok daripada carta yang ada tu, bermula pada tahun 2016, which is very humble beginning dengan niat nak bantu kawan. Jualan kita pada tu, 2016, 8.6 juta. Dan sehingga bulan 11, jualan untuk tahun 2021 ni, baru sampai 11 bulan kita dah mencapai 145 juta jualan melalui home dealer ni saja. Ia adalah 35% daripada jualan syarikat. Dan kita berkongsi pendapatan, kita bagi pendapatan pada home dealer ni sebanyak 50 juta setahun. Jadi itu adalah antara pencapaian yang kami rasa yang kita dah buat. Dan bagi saya, social micro entrepreneur ni adalah satu kaedah bagaimana kita menjalankan tanggungjawab sosial kita. Selain daripada kita buat bisnes kita, kita juga boleh bagi opportunity kepada rakan sekeliling. Dan bagi saya, ini adalah jentera yang kita bina pada tahun 2016. Dan apabila pandemik terjadi pada hari ini, jentera yang kita bina ni dapat digunakan kerana orang dah COD pada waktu pandemik. Pada pandemik orang COD. Tapi kalau you tak ada jentera, tak COD, tapi dekat Farm Fresh kita dah buat jentera tu. Jadi masa pandemik datang, kebanyakan daripada home dealer kita tak terjejas. Alhamdulillah diorang masih dapat rezeki dan boleh membiayai keluarga dia. Tak ada yang angkat bendera putih. Dan saya selalu tanya diorang, masa pandemik sale okey tak? Alhamdulillah sale okey, kerana kita dah tersedia dengan servis kita yang ada. Tapi impak yang paling besar yang kita di syarikat rasa ialah kita dapat mengubah kehidupan suri rumah tangga daripada kita nak suruh dia berniaga secara kecilan untuk membantu keluarga dia menambah pendapatan. Dia dapat mengubah kehidupan mereka sekarang ini. Dan kebanyakan daripada mereka hidup senang. Dan untuk ini juga, Farm Fresh telah diberi Inclusive Business Award semasa ASEAN Summit 2020. Alhamdulillah apa yang kita capaikan ini, dan kita dekat syarikat akan terus fokus untuk develop mereka ini daripada fasa ke fasa. Dan rasanya kita akan siapkan beberapa fasa supaya mereka terus berkembang. Daripada usahawan mikro tadi, dia boleh jadi usahawan PKS, dan insyaAllah mereka satu hari, if Farm Fresh sebagai platform untuk mereka belajar dan untuk mereka dapat pengalaman dan mereka kumpulkan modal, kalau mereka boleh jadi usahawan besar, kami juga rasa berbesar hati atas apa yang telah kami contribute. I think that's all apa yang saya nak sampaikan. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum.